my...
Greetings. Want to join the lists?
Naturally. We must first see to formalities, however. At Guillaume's request, I have looked into your personal history in its heraldic aspects.
Really? What did you come up with?
My findings show you may take part as Geralt of Rivia.
What a surprise.
Or as the Honorable Ravix of Forhorn. It's not every year we have a combatant who can boast of two crests. Which do you prefer?
The Honorable Ravix will do.
You may now take the shield bearing your crest.
I'm a witcher. Shields aren't something witchers ever use in combat.
Who mentioned using it in combat? Not I. The shield commemorates your participation in the tourney. You may take it as a souvenir.
In that case, thanks.
Have you been instructed as to the tourney's challenges, prizes, and vows? If not, I do hope you will allow me to tell you about them.
Feels like I know everything I'd ever want to know about chivalric tourneys.
Splendid. In that case, you must make your vow. Upon what would you like to swear it?
I vow on the love of my lady, Triss Marigold, to respect the chivalric virtues.
May the gods succor you in your endeavors to overcome. A sign here, please, then fill out these forms. That is all I need from you. Now, as arranged by Guillaume, you shall be fitted with appropriate armor for the tourney.
Shiny.
You have also been assigned a tent for the tourney's duration. It stands near the arena. Good luck.
Geralt, well, I'll be. Have you decided to turn knight-errant?
All jesting aside, here on a job. You in the tourney too?
Am I? Ha! I shall square off against Renfarn of Atre. I saw him just moments ago, a nervous wreck, stuffing his nose with fish steak, no less, as if that would aid his determination.
Guessing that's against the rules.
But who's to tell the Nifgardian what to do? Listen, Geralt, I've a tip for you. The timing of your marksmanship duel is such that you shall have the sun in your eyes.
Makes no difference to me either way.
Nor will it give you any pleasure. Since, as it is, we must both wait, play me in a round of Gwent. Should you win, I shall swap with you. To me, a southerner, the sun is no hindrance.
Thanks. Another time, maybe.
Ha! You've denied me some diversion. But at the least, my eyes are in for a treat. Lady Vivian should appear shortly.
Fair knights, I salute you! The honor and duty of tourney patron have fallen to me this year. Fight honorably, so that I may bestow upon one of your number the tourney's grand prize! You have sworn your vows. You have readied body and soul. The time has come to test them!
Behold, Horm Akispark! off the Mechtian royal line. His name's quite the mouthful, a true challenge to rhyme. His targets to be hit centrally and true are the ones in blue. Against him, new blood, a knight unknown till now. Seraphics of Forhorn, give us a bow! The targets he must with his quarrel's thread are red.
May the better man win.
Seraphix has hit over one half of his marks. Will he manage to prevail? Are these glory's first sparks? Ravix. Seraphix has won. His boat struck the goal. Yet even this cannot soothe the ache in his soul.
Your prize, sir. A crossbow adorned with your crest. I congratulate you.
Thank you, my lady. Would you tell me about the other prizes?
Alas, I cannot devote more time to you than to the other combatants. I have duties to attend to. Forgive me.
My medallion's vibrating strongly. Can only mean one thing. Magic.
The explanation is disappointing, I'm afraid. The fragrance I use, it's mixed by a sorceress.
To lose to an opponent such as you is a victory of its own. Accept my congratulations as well.
Thanks.
Good work!
In the interim, I managed to determine which tent Lady Vivian occupies. Perhaps you could find a clue within it.
You're right. Vivian's cursed in some way. Sensed it when she opened the tourney.
In that case, we've no time to lose. Let us go.
Yeah, let's go now.
This is her tent. You must look inside. Search it. I shall hoot like an owl should someone approach.
Claw marks, that's clear. Not sure what beast left them, just that it's big.
Oh, fair Vivian. Thou hast
Oriole feather. Vivian keep a bird as a pet? No sign of it here, if so. Bruxae tend to be fond of birds. Used to make compresses. Clothing's all dark green and yellow. Seems Yen's not the only one with a fixed color scheme.
Someone approaches, quickly!
You were supposed to hoot.
We shall speak later. We must return to the tourney now. It's time for the second contest.
Sirs, what seek you in my lady's tent? Inspiration? Be gone from here.
Right.
Behold, gallant knights and ladies decorous! Gaze at the host assembled before us! Look upon chivalry's best and most storied! Come from far lands, here to seek glory! Hear now their names as I shout them aloud! Savor their titles, of their presence be proud! Palmerin the Baron of Longfall! Linus of Metina! Rainfarn of Atra! Horm Macaspark of Maecht! Donimir of Troy! Guy de Boisfren, in service to the Duchess! Delwyn of Craigiel! Count Ty of Dondal! And say of Lyria and Rivia a prince! Graphics of Forhorn! For Gregoire of Mount Gorgon, let out a roaring cheer! The faint fire of silence, tawny champion from last year! Today's winner of contests, his victory to secure, shall face Sir Gregoire in a challenge severe!
Does ignorance demand a bardic deceit? Does someone need telling how tourneys proceed?
Yes, I do, if you please.
Ere the sands from the glass retire?
Any chance you could say it normally?
Not at all. Ere the sands from the glass retire, and hearty toil your steed does tire, neath all the gates you must guide your horse, and each of five targets strike with bolts. Each dummy felt adds more sand to the glass, and each true shot bolt repeats the task.
Yep, all clear now.
Raphics of Forhorn, is that what you call yourself? The shot flew me. To this day I bear marks where I met your steel. But don't you remember? I am Ty of Dorntal. And I swear to you, before the tourney's end, I shall have added another book to that collection on your muck!
Done. Then step aside. You're in my way.
The tourney's protector, the mate Vivian! Her beauty entrances both beasts and men!
My heart's greetings, dear knights! May my grace guide you and show you the path of honor! Valor and glory! Accept my wishes of good fortune, sir, and devote all your strength to the tourney, and only it.
The time has come for you, sir knight. Mount your steed. Swift be your flight.
Ladies and gentlemen of lineage illustrious, soon steeds shall swarm like ants most industrious. To beat time's passage, they'll ride like the gale. What a sight to behold! What a lark! What a tale! Before us, ceramics of Forhorn dupped, his spurs flashed like lightning to a shine they've been wrapped. And he's up! With a thunderous roar, hoofs pound the ground. No legion of drummers could make such a sound! Will he last into your... Such style, such grace, such speed. To watch was a pleasure, a treat indeed. To honor our entrance, praise each fair knight. We shall feast from eve till dawn's first light. The finest of wine and food shall be served. If you've blood in your veins, come collect what's deserved.
I congratulate you. Here, your prize. A saddle adorned with your crest. By the way, my mate saw a man with white hair sneak out of my tent. Would you know who it might have been?
No idea.
How juvenile.
Congratulations on your win. In stellar style, no less. Ah, I no longer regret I was not able to participate. Almost.
We must drink to this. Come with me to the feast. We shall await Vivian together.
Lead the way.
So, any thoughts on Vivian?
Her beauty's striking.
That is not what I ask.
Still too early to say anything I'd be willing to stand behind. Found some clues. Got me wondering if your beloved Vivian's not a Bruxa.
A Bruxa? You mean a vampiress?
Not sure yet.
We've still some time before Vivian arrives. Let us drink. To Vivian. May you find the means to aid her.
To Vivian.
Ah, when I first laid eyes on her, I finally understood what all those poems and ballads were trying to say.
Love's not poetry alone. Sometimes it's prose. Sometimes it's just plain ugly.
You say that only because you do not know Vivian as I do. A life with her would be sweetness itself.
Actually, you don't know her all that well either. Dropped something.
I demand satisfaction. You've insulted me twicely.
And twicely ought to be enough.
You refuse to duel? Then I shall show you how I treat cowards.
Nothing, Ty. Might want to give some serious thought to whether you want to face me for a fourth.
I shall kill you, freak!
You got your chance, sir. You failed to seize it, and now you must leave.
We shall meet again, mutant.
Thank you.
My heart swells to behold this beautiful celebration of valor and honor, and to witness you, who embody the chivalric virtues in your lives, strive for greatness. Yet, after a time of combat must come a time of peace and respite. Thus, I invite all who fought in the tourney to this feast held in your, and none other's, honor. And should any among you crave solitude, private tents await you nearby. The group melee shall take place on the morrow. Glory shall be within grasp for each and every one of you. The best among you shall have the honor to face our reigning champion, the famed Gregoire de Gourgon, victor of last year's tourney. Celebrate, make merry, revel as you will, yet be mindful of the trial that awaits you tomorrow.
Follow her. We shall meet in your tent before your last contest. You must help her.
How am I to enjoy an evening?
That grey domed scoundrel ever seeking lady.
Strange. Was sure I'd find her here. Vanished. Melted into thin air. And that bird, Shiaproxa, flew off. Worth going after. Looks like the bird's leading me somewhere.
What now, you piece of...
over the hill. Might be quicker to pass through the cave.
Witcher.
Lady Vivian? Counted on me getting lost.
I did. I thought you no different from the knights. Good at tourneys, hopeless in the face of true danger. I was mistaken.
So you're not actually a Bruxa?
A what?
Suspicion I had that you might be a vampire. Certain details seemed to confirm it. Then I changed my mind. Anyway, unimportant. Here you come to this clearing often.
This is where it all began. And as I was not able to evade you, save myself from you, then I want it done here. In this very spot, with no witnesses.
Want what done?
Why, you are a witcher. You were hired to kill me, were you not? Then do so, now. And do it quickly, I beg you. I shan't resist.
Witchers only hunt monsters, and even then, not all. You're no monster.
Then what am I to your eyes?
Most likely you've been cursed. Don't know who by or why yet, but hope to find that out soon.
If you've no contract on my life, why take an interest at all? Did Guillaume put you up to it? Is that why?
He wanted to help you. Asked me to do him a favor. Frankly, if I can do something for you, I'll do it, willingly.
Why should I trust you?
'Cause the Duchess trusts me? 'Cause I'm a freak, too? 'Cause cases like yours are my bread and butter. Take your pick.
You shall not turn on me. Use what I say against me. You shall not tell anyone.
Can't promise anything till I hear what you have to say. Decisions based on appearances? Not a good idea. Regretted making those too often in the past.
So be it. I shall tell you what my mama once told me. When she was with child, expecting me, she and my father spent much time together near the wood, here in this clearing. Mama loved to listen to the orioles sing. She would stroke her belly and say, "My daughter should be as beautiful as that bird. Such is my wish." But a creature dwelt in the wood who envied my parents their happiness. One day it appeared before them to say the whole wood belonged to it, and they had dared to delight in something that was not theirs. It demanded payment. And when my parents said that they had nothing, it claimed their unborn daughter as its own.
Parents ever describe the creature?
They called it a nymph born of the deep woods, with no mother or father. But I was too young, too distraught by the curse's onset to ask after details.
What happened after that?
Nothing at first. I came into the world a perfectly normal child, and my parents forgot that day's events. But 15 summers into my life, the curse began to show. Initially only when the moon was full, but now it's advanced so that even in daytime I must use magic ointment to mask its symptoms, to look normal. Thus, I thought someone had discovered my secret, then hired you to kill me. In fact, I was resigned to death in coming here. Perhaps death would be preferable to my complete and permanent transformation. For I fear that is what lies in store.
Ointment you use includes a potent magic ingredient. You don't have the immunity mages have. Use heavy doses, or normal doses too long, and it could be dangerous to you.
I sensed this. The very reason I knew I would have to give it up in the end, and bid my human form a final farewell.
The curse. It could be reversible. Once ran into a baron transformed into a cormorant, ostensibly for good. Managed to cure him completely.
And you truly think you could do something like this for me?
Can't guarantee a thing. Tough case, yours. You were cursed before birth. That alone complicates things. Also, you claim the curse is increasing its hold. Symptoms are progressing. Could try transferring the curse onto someone else.
What? Out of the question. I shall not allow it to ruin an innocent's life. Is this the only method you know?
Only one that's completely safe.
So there is another.
Pretty quick to reject help. Why is that? The curse once transferred would probably have a weaker hold on the new host. Lots weaker.
I do not even wish to hear of it.
All right. There is another. Ancient ritual. We'd need an Oriole egg. Should release the curse's grip permanently. Gotta warn you, though. Could have serious consequences.
Consequences? What kind?
Curse was cast before you came into this world. Ritual involved transferring it to an as-yet unhatched chick. You'd be free. Thing is, you could be left with the average lifespan of an Oriole.
7 years. I understand. Alas, every rose has its thorn, and there are no happy endings. Yet truth be told, I never thought I would get one. I came here prepared to die, yet you wish to give me 7 years of life. Real life, free life. This is no dilemma. I agree, wholeheartedly.
I see why. I understand. Don't have to decide just yet. Think it through.
I will. They must miss me at the tawny grounds by now. Shall we? Return.
Let's. But are you gonna...
Yes. I cannot appear there all in feathers. Pardon me for a moment.
You can change at will?
No, but I discovered the water of this pool helps. Its effects are brief, but I can always be sure of them.
Interesting.
Come.
Did you learn anything?
Yeah.
Then speak, man. Can you not see I'm out of my mind with worry? What ails her?
She asked me not to talk about it.
But I want only the best for her. Perhaps I shall be able to help or, I don't know, console her at the least.
We were both right, actually. It is a curse. One that's transforming Vivian into a bird. Her condition's getting worse.
Gods! A curse that is a worse affliction than disease. What now? Can you help her?
That'll depend on her. I'll try if she asks me. Significant risks involved, though. Shortening her life to about another 7 years included.
What? This is not what we agreed.
Tough case. Curse's hold on her grows stronger every day. And I'm a witcher, not a miracle worker. Heard of one other method that could work. Curse could be lifted via her reflection, say in a pool of water. Thing is, we'd need someone who'd willingly assume the burden of the curse. Take it on in her stead.
You mean, become a bird themselves?
Theoretically. See, curse grows weaker once it's transferred. Might end up as just an appetite for seeds and worms. All outcomes are on the table, though. Death included.
I am prepared to sacrifice. Give my life for her. Just as King Friedank's knight did for the beautiful Queen Sero.
Knew that already. But are you prepared to swallow bugs for the rest of your life?
Yes. Which method do you believe to be best for Vivian?
Don't know yet.
But you have some notion, have you not? Do not tell me you seriously consider drastically shortening her life when I stand prepared to shoulder the burden.
Method using a pool of water is better. Poses no threat to Vivian.
Naturally. You must know you can count on me. I shall bear it all. But Vivian, I fear she might be too proud to agree to such a thing.
I'll meet her after the last contest. Talk to her. She could agree.
I'm counting on you, Witcher. And I'm content we finally know something. What now? We know all, so you need not see the tourney through. You could withdraw. True, I shall get an earful from the Herald should you fail to show for the last contest. But it's nothing I can't handle. So, what will it be?
I don't back out of anything. I'll take part in the last skirmish. Besides, Vivian will be busy till the tourney's end.
Indeed. In that case, you must meet the other knights of your team. They await near the arena's entrance, by the training ground.
Got it. Thanks.
I know now the two teams' rosters. I shall be captain of ours. That means you shall do as I say for the duration of the fight. Is this clear? Palmer and Alonful will lead the opposing team. With this skirmish, we commemorate the Battle of Fox Hollow of 1218, when a handful of southern outlaws led by Hallar the Brown attacked Tucson only to be driven off by brave knights, thus setting a precedent. Since that day, knights errant have guarded the duchy's borders. Palmerin drew the short straw, so his team shall play the barbarian Hallersman. Any questions?
None.
If you swing your blade as deftly as you shoot, we shall win. Good luck.
It is time, gentlemen. Take your weapons and proceed to the arena.
Cheer for the knights, the ladies, the lords. For our next entertainment, the team shall cross swords. Two rifle crews, two coteries shall fight full tilt till one's dropped to its knees. Whose virtue is laws or lance blows unclean shall forever be branded as shameful, obscene. While the knights prepare, let me say I'm elated to behold such a crowd on edge, breath-baited. Whoever here wins, the past champion shall face. All others must leave, heads bowed in disgrace. Let us begin! Crowd, raise a ruckus! Blood, sweat, and tears shall soon follow in buckets.
there's but Rathics, though he's far from done. When all the dust clears, shall he have won? Or me, or my, that must have been painful. Like a thorn to the heart, only more baneful. The world's never seen a fight quite so glorious. For showing such verve, each knight was victorious. Yet at tourney's end, but one champion may reign. Today it is Palmerin, all praise to his name. That lions, like leopards, so fierce fought his host. To them give your cheers, love, esteem utmost. Palmerin de Longfall and Gregoire de Gorgon, two knights of high valor shall fight to be champion. Noble Seraphics shall not stand in La Belle. Though hopes he raised high, a victory short, he fell. To the tired remainder, we salute your endeavors. Return to your wives, your loves, your whomevers.
Come back quickly.
I know now the two part with
none.
If you swear,
it is time.
A chair to let us begin. Crowd, Rissa Ruckus. Blood, sweat, and tears shall soon follow in buckets.
Come! Succumb to death's embrace! No mercy!
World sniffers, yet like lions, like leopards, so fierce fought his host. To them give Palmer in the Longfall and Gregoire, nobles to the tired tremend.
Greetings, my lady. Have you decided?
I have. I stand by all I have said. I wish to endanger no one and thus choose the method involving an egg. If it's to be the egg of an oriole, I know where to find one. There is a nest in my clearing. Might you explain the nature of the ritual? Its exact course?
Sure. Want to tell you something, though. Think we should try the alternate method first.
I was clear. It is out of the question.
Let me finish. Second method's less than reliable. To put it simply, might work, might not.
But it will. I shall save you, oh lovely Vivian.
Why are you here, sir? This is a private conversation.
No need to be sharp with him, my lady. And if I'm to help you, gotta do one thing for me. Hear what Guillaume has to say.
Is that an ultimatum?
Looks to be.
Be not angry, my lady. You no longer bear this burden alone. I know all.
You told him!
I know a curse afflicts you, a curse which grows more severe by the day. I understand how you feel. My aunt, Countess de Lawnful, once contracted a strange illness which ate away at her from the inside. She grew weaker by the day, the light fading from her eyes. I remember her saying the worst was not the pain, but losing mastery of her own body. She was so helpless. I fear you feel the same. The Witcher knows a way to lift the curse from you and let it rest on me. I wish to do this, to take it from you, Vivian.
Why?
Because I love you. I might have died in the arena. I sought to slay a Shalmar for you. But now I see the fool I was. Now I see how I risked my life for no purpose. Yet, with this, I can truly do something for you.
I do not wish to inflict this horror on anyone. You saw how it looks, Witcher. I turn to you as one elder and hopefully one wiser as well. Do you think this a good idea?
Worth a try, as I see it. Original curse fell on an unborn child. Doubt it'll take hold as strongly when transferred to a full-grown man.
You've now hurt the expert opinion. Let us do this together, Vivian.
Very well. I was prepared to die. Thus, I am also prepared to attempt something mad. Now, we must go to my pool in the woods, yes?
Everything's agreed, so no point wasting any more time. Let's go.
The aunt you mentioned. What became of her?
She passed on.
Die, beast!
Lady Vivian!
So, this is my true form. It is not too late. You may still change your mind. It will bring no shame.
My mind is made up. My resolve is firm. If you can handle it, so will I. You are beautiful to me, even as you stand now.
Oh, that's clearly rubbish.
Shut your eyes, both of you, and don't move.
Guillaume?
Yes, my love?
If you become as I am now, I wish you to know I shall not leave you.
Picture yourselves reflected in a pool of water. Focus on that. Open your eyes. Damn. Think it might have worked. How do you feel? In general, you feel it change, Guillaume?
I was struck hard, as if by a battering ram, but now I feel not at all different. Apart from a slight itch on my skin. Are you certain it worked?
Yes, something happened, definitely. Must be an intersection beneath this pond. Powerful magic at work here. Look at Vivian.
What now?
Now? Now you get to live together, happily ever after. Still, watch yourselves carefully. Notice any troubling symptoms, find me.
Naturally. I thank you, Geralt. Oh, and your payment.
At last! I've so much to make up for. Balls to attend, distant lands to see.
Free at last, as a bird.
Ha! Huh? I find you droll. I had not noticed before.
But you will not fly away without me.
That remains to be seen, I think. But I too must thank you, Witcher.
Don't mention it. You take care, both.